welcome the next president of the United States, President Donald J. Trump.
This election is a choice between whether we will have a four more years. Could you stand it? It's 4 more years of incompetence and stupidity and failure and disaster, or whether we will begin the 4 greatest years in the history of our country. I think we have a real chance. And we were set back. We were set back. And then you think about what they've done, because I happen to think the border is the biggest problem we have, not inflation. Inflation's terrible. It's a country buster. And the economy, all those things. But I happen to think that what they've done at the border to our country by letting millions and millions of people in, totally unchecked and unvetted, I think it's the worst thing, including murderers, drug dealers, people from prison. They opened up their prisons of the world into our country. I think it's the worst thing anyone's ever heard. And a lot of terrorists are coming in. Record numbers of terrorists. Nothing good can happen. Nothing good can happen.
Not about it through a man that builds the plants. I said, I want to see a plant. I want to see a car plant. He said, come with me to Mexico, sir. I said, no, I want to see one in the United States. We don't build the big ones in the United States. The big ones are being built in Mexico. I said, why is that? Well, China's there, and they want to build them in Mexico and then sell them into the United States, which will totally close down the electric chair. And by the way, does anybody have any doubt? Right there. And then everything else is going to start to come down. Your cost.
Biden put this total stupid person in charge of our border. Think of it. Never made a call. Never went there. She let it just all, that she said, keep those borders open, let everybody come in. Now, there's only one reason you do that, I guess. Well, there's 3 reasons. You're stupid. You hate our country. You can't be that stupid to be able to cheat like they cheat. So you're either stupid, you hate our country, or they're trying to get them to vote, right? And it's probably the third. She has resettled some of the worst criminals anywhere in the world into your communities to prey upon innocent American citizens. When I win on November 5th, the migrant invasion ends and the restoration of our country begins. Okay? Now they're happy. Now she's happy. He's happy now.
A license for that, right? You know, the fake news is protected.
I will invoke the Alien Enemies Act of 1798. Think of that. 1798. That's when we had real politicians that said, we're not going to play games. We have to go back to 1798 to target and dismantle every migrant criminal network operating on American soil. We're going to knock the hell out of them.
Kamala has imported an army of illegal alien gang members and migrant criminals from.
What do you think, Whatley? How good is Whatley? What do you think? You know, he's running the whole shebang. He ran your state. As you know, the Republican Party, we did so well. I said, put him in charge of everything this time. He'll stop the cheating. He's going to stop the cheating. How are you doing? Are they cheating, Michael? They're trying, but are they? They're not going to get away with it, right? He said, no. That's why I had him. They didn't get away with it in this day. They got away with it in plenty of places. This will be America's new golden age. It's going to happen. Every problem facing us can be solved, but now the fate of our nation is in your hands. North Carolina, you have to stand up and you have to tell Kamala Harris that you've had enough. You can't take it anymore. She's the worst vice president in history. It's the worst administration in the history of our country. They make Jimmy Carter look like he was a great president. He's a very happy man. Kamala, you're the absolute epitome of, I won't say it. Kamala, you're fired. Get the hell out of here. Get out. Get out of here, Kamala.
The Congo in Africa, many people are being brought in from the Congo.
Kamala Harris does not have the compassion, the smarts, or the strength to be the president of the United States. She just can't do the job.
They said, no way. I said, way. And then they started wondering, what the hell's going on over?
She's a mess. She's a cognitive mess, and nobody wants to talk about it. And we can't have four more years. We had 4 years of it. We can't take another 4 years of it, can we?
I'm going to tariff you for 25%, then for 50%, then for...
Did you ever hear the expression that the vote counter is far more important than the candidate? And unfortunately, we can't let that happen. We've got to take it back.
That's the biggest scandal in the history of broadcasting.
But I watched how bad they were doing. They were destroying this country step by step. They were destroying it. I love Elon, by the way. You know, he makes all those electric cars. But he understands that, too. He's got a great, he makes a great car, great part, and a lot of people like it. It's a perfect application for a lot, but not for everybody. Someone gasoline propelled, and we have a lot of gasoline right under there, and some want other things. They want to have a hybrid. The one thing I can't get used to is hydrogen, you know? You know the story with hydrogen? It's great until it blows up, in which case you're not recognizable. Even guys, strong guys like this, they'd call you mom or your wife. Is it a mom or a, oh, look at that. Oh, I know them. Very wealthy parents. That's nice, you know? I know them. No, your kids wouldn't be recognizable. That's not a good thought, huh? How's my son doing? Well, he tried the new hydrogen car. It didn't work out too well.
In the dictionary is the word tariff. You don't.
I was on the phone talking to a very important guy, actually, and I have the television muted. It's dead muted. And I see this ball of fire come, like a 20-story building. It's coming down, coming. I say, would you do me a favor, hold it? I've never said, what the hell is happening? I thought maybe it switched over to a movie or something. And I put the phone down. Very important guy. You know what? I never picked it up. The guy was holding for like 45 minutes. I forgot he was on the phone because... And now they all these idiots back there will say, he's cognitively impaired because he put the... He's cognitively impaired! Wait, from this beautiful place. It's beautiful. Linda McMahon, I mean, I could tell you about her for days. She went here, right? And you loved it. I said, you like it? She said, I loved it. I'm very proud to have my beautiful daughter, Tiffany, here with her husband, Michael. And they're going to have a baby, a beautiful baby. Two good people.
And I even said, we'll put 100, 200, I don't care what the number is. They're not going to have one car. And these stupid people, stupid politicians, they don't like to build the factory in China. We don't want your cars. Japan. Japan doesn't take our cars. They said,
we will make America great again. Thank you very much. God bless you. God bless you all.